Robot Entertainment has announced that two of their games, Orcs Must Die Unchained and Heroes Academies 2, which I believe is a mobile game, I'm not 100% sure, but essentially these games are going to be shutting down April 8th, and the reason being that they have given is that they were no longer able to financially support the games. Apparently they've been running for several months at a financial loss, and essentially they don't have the money to continue this, and this is supported by the fact that earlier in the year, or at least in 2018, the fact that they actually had to do some layoffs and kind of reschedule the way that they were actually developing video games. They had two games in the works and they were apparently narrowing it down to one. Supposedly this is going to be part of their restructuring because they just quite frankly don't have any money, and that's kind of unfortunate because Orcs Must Die was actually a pretty fun game. Michael here with another topic video. So today I kind of want to talk about the history of Orcs Must Die a little bit and talk about where I think it kind of failed when it came down to Orcs Must Die Unchained. I can't really talk about Heroes Academies 2 very much. It looked like one of those standard lane defense mobile games which didn't really seem all that interesting to me, and so I could very easily see that that's one of those games that ended up failing just because there wasn't a market for it. The free-to-play market on mobile is quite competitive, and if you don't have something that appeals immediately to people, then you're quite frankly just not going to get anybody to really play your game, and that's just an unfortunate reality no matter how good your game is. Even there's some absolutely fantastic games on mobile that just don't do particularly well because they don't capture a large enough audience, and this is just a reality of the platform, quite frankly, which is a little bit unfortunate, but there you go. But again, I never played it, so I can't really talk too much about it or say anything about it in that sort of term, which is a little bit unfortunate, but there you go. That's how it goes about. But when it comes down to Orcs Must Die Unchained, I actually played this back all the way in the closed beta of the game, and I was actually quite excited to try it. Now, Orcs Must Die was never my favorite one. The game in the background is Dungeon Defenders, which this is my favorite little action dungeon crawly defense game that I actually enjoy quite a bit. So basically, Orcs Must Die was kind of in the same vein to where basically you had platforms that you were able to set traps on, and it was basically just a tower defense game, but it had action elements. Now, the idea behind Unchained, unfortunately, wasn't to keep that going. Instead, what they ended up focusing on later on, and this is a mistake that Dungeon Defenders also ended up having with Dungeon Defenders 2, and it's probably one of the major reasons why Dungeon Defenders 2 just ended up not being a particularly interesting game still to this day, is the fact that they ended up trying to go the free-to-play route, and they tried to shift genres. The original game was supposed to be a MOBA, and so when they were announcing it's going to be multiplayer-focused, of course they still had traps and such, as in you had, you know, little lane minions that were basically just orcs, and then they'd go through and they would have all these different traps that were trying to stop them and such. It was actually kind of fun. But the problem was that that's not the reason why people liked Orcs Must Die, and the reason why people kind of steered away from a lot of MOBAs was just the fact that it was overcrowded in the market. We already have some large games in there, and this is still something that we see companies struggle with today, is making a good MOBA isn't easy, and making one that's interesting is even harder. And so basically, they just ran into the problem to where they couldn't make a good enough MOBA. And this ended up leading to a lot of people just leaving the game extremely early and not really giving it much of a chance. Now, carry that on into the future, they ended up learning from their mistake, and this is actually quite honorable from them. And they were like, hey, okay, so people really like the tower defense stuff. So they ended up adding in this optional co-op mode. And actually, that's what I ended up spending a lot of time on, and it was actually kind of fun. It was fairly basic when it came down to it. I have no idea what defenses to build, and I'm kind of confused. I think I'm just going to build a bunch of archers. Sorry, I'm getting focused on the game in the background. This isn't the best game for the background, but there you go. But that was actually the mode I enjoyed, and it was actually kind of fun. However, the maps and stuff like that weren't quite designed for it, but supposedly they were working on fixing that. And so they're like, hey, we're going to make it so that this actually works, and they ended up kind of shifting focus into a co-op sort of tower defense game. And in that sort of vein, it wasn't bad, actually. The problem with it was, again, that it was free to play. Now, when it comes down to free to play and a multiplayer focus, these are the major two things that I think ended up actually killing off the game. Now, obviously, if it was buy to play, the MOBA system wouldn't have worked. But again, this kind of goes into the same vein to where after they ended up ditching the MOBA aspect, we kind of went into this multiplayer focus of where it ended up keeping this multiplayer focus in a genre that really, really worked as a solo experience. Again, I'm playing Dungeon Defenders in the background because I can. It's a solo experience and enjoyable in that way, and because of it, it's still a game I end up going back to. Orcs Must Die, the 1 and 2, I don't necessarily go back to them because, again, I said I wasn't a particularly fan of them. I don't want to play her, I want to play somebody else. But it ends up being one of those games that people can go back to, and I do know quite a few people that have ended up going back to them and just enjoying them as an experience, just as something they wanted to end up playing, and it's quite enjoyable in that route. Now, for me, Orcs Must Die was always more on the basic kind of casual, just I want to chill out and just zone for a bit. And that's kind of the experience I ended up getting out of those games. But Orcs Must Die Unchained was a little bit different and a little bit more complex, and it had some interesting ideas, such as it had a hero system that was kind of carried over from the MOBA. But again, this plays back into the free-to-play kind of system, to where basically they were locking progression behind all these different systems because, again, a free-to-play game, especially back in the day when this came out, which was back in like 2016, to be honest. I think it was back in 2016 when this game originally came out into open beta. And basically just that free-to-play model kind of screwed over with the progression systems. But I think that's ultimately what kind of killed it, was the multiplayer focus that carried over from the MOBA version of the game. The game was very, very difficult to enjoy single player, and it wasn't one of those types of games that I ended up sticking with for that reason, because I couldn't get friends to go and play it. The tower defense genre, for as fun as it is and for as much as I enjoy it, it is a niche genre. And I think that when companies were trying to do this, and there's several of them that have tried to do this, you kind of have to keep that in mind, and you kind of have to make compromises to actually make a multiplayer focused tower defense game. And it just doesn't end up working most of the time, and it takes a lot of effort, and you actually have to market the game as well. The game wasn't marketed particularly well, and I didn't really see any marketing for it after its initial launch. After it went to open beta, that was pretty much the last I heard of it. The last time it actually showed up in my email list was actually back in early 2017, to where they were like, hey, we're switching to a co-op focus. And that's the last time I ever actually heard about the game, and I almost completely forgot it existed until I saw the announcement that it was shutting down, which probably isn't a good sign for your marketing. And another reason for that being is that people, again, just weren't playing the game, which actually probably plays in back to the queues and the multiplayer focus. Again, it wasn't a game that was particularly fun to play solo. And so when you went into a free-to-play game that wasn't very well known, you run into long queue times. And even back in 2017, when I was playing it, queue times were extremely long, and the competitive modes were still sort of a thing back then as well, which meant that it was actually divided by six different queues, if I remember correctly. So yeah, I'd have to go back and look at our original footage. Actually, I don't even think I have that original footage. I think that video never actually released, so I don't even think I have a video on it. But yeah, that's probably where it ended up failing. And it's actually kind of honorable that they were able to keep it up and keep it going for so long. I'm actually curious to see how many people were actually playing it. I haven't looked up the stats or anything like that, but I'm actually curious. And it's unfortunate that it kind of goes down, because I actually liked some of the concepts. I like the idea of having a tower defense game to where you actually have heroes and stuff like that. I think that's a really cool and interesting idea that probably doesn't get enough exposure and enough companies kind of trying it out. Like Dungeon Defenders, for example, is probably the best kind of tower defense action game that I can think of that sort of does the hero systems well and stuff. And that's kind of unfortunate. I wish there were more of them, and it's a genre I really, really enjoy. And so me kind of seeing this niche genre not really, you know, have a lot of games in it, and having another one end up shutting down that I had completely forgotten about, I'll be 100% honest. I completely forgot about its existence. I don't think I want that. So yeah, I don't know. It's just kind of weird. And I completely forgot it existed, which is probably another reason why I ended up shutting down. But basically that's kind of the route of it. So Robot Entertainment isn't shutting down, thankfully. They're probably just going to keep on going and working on another project. I'm actually excited to see what they end up going out with, because, well, you know, again, not a big fan of Orcs Must Die and all that, it might actually, you know, come out with something great next, and I'm actually excited to see. And if they end up doing a tower defense style game, I would love to actually see what it is, because we haven't had a good entry in the tower defense field for quite a long time. So I think it's actually quite a good genre to jump into if they were going to. Of course, they've already been working on it for quite a while. They did actually have two different projects going on until layoffs earlier in 2018, so I don't necessarily know what they're doing here, but they were kind of going on to the mobile market and stuff like that. And I think the trend chasing that they did with Orcs Must Die probably ended up killing off that franchise, because again, they were chasing the whole MOBA trend, they were chasing the whole free-to-play trend, they were chasing the multiplayer only trend as well, and all of that combined probably ended up killing off a lot of their goodwill from a lot of different people that would have ended up enjoying their products regardless, which, you know, not necessarily a bad thing. We all make mistakes, and I think a lot of companies have made that mistake in the past, especially indies have definitely made that mistake multiple times, and I think it's kind of unfortunate. And looking back at sort of Orcs Must Die Unchained, again, I'm talking about how there's not a lot of competition inside of that space. The only other free-to-play sort of multiplayer-focused tower defense game I can think of is Dungeon Defenders 2, which isn't very good. In fact, it's an absolutely terrible tower defense game. It's more of just a grind fest for loot, and it's not very fun. And so, honestly, Orcs Must Die Unchained was actually fun when I played it. I remember enjoying my time with it. I just didn't have the time to invest in another free-to-play grind fest. And so, again, that probably ended up killing off the experience for me, quite frankly. But I think it would have actually been a good opportunity if they had advertised it well and actually did some good overhauls. Like, let's say they did a good overhaul and ended up advertising it for, like, the Xbox One and PS4 and all that. You know, an audience that doesn't have Dungeon Defenders 2, I don't think. You know, so basically there would be next to no competition for that style of game whatsoever. And so they could have actually ended up capturing an audience that way. But again, I don't think they actually had the financial standing to actually take that sort of risk, which I could definitely imagine them trying it. But seeing as they weren't advertising it to begin with, and the game had been in development for so long and had kind of been a financial failure at that point, I can definitely see them being like, maybe that's not such a good idea, just because, you know, kind of riding on the coattails of something that wasn't particularly great to begin with in a financial sense probably wouldn't have been a good idea. So I can definitely see why they didn't go for that, but again, it's just kind of unfortunate. It's an unfortunate story, and a lot of times, you know, games are always shutting down. I ended up skipping over a lot of the news stories for this one, but this one kind of had an interesting backstory, and I kind of like to talk about how all these companies kind of like to try and chase the popular trends and end up failing because of it, because basically just you need to make an original product, and if you're trying to chase a trend, you're not doing that, and you need to stand out. But it's kind of a weird case because there's not a lot of tower defense games that are really, really good. So, yeah, it's a bit strange. Anyways, thank you guys so much for watching. Make sure to like and subscribe for more contents like this one. And, of course, you can leave your comments below in the comment section if you actually ended up playing it in its final days. They actually are doing a little event thing right now to where basically for the ending until the end of the game to where it basically shuts down on April 8th, which, how close is that? That's actually pretty far away, actually. They're giving out, like, huge amounts of currency. So, basically, if you want to go and try it, you can go and try it without all the free-to-play grind and stuff like that, because they'll just be throwing currency around so that people can enjoy the last few days of it, you know, to kind of honor the fans and stuff like that. I assume it's closing down April 8th because their servers, or like the pay structure for their servers, are going to shut down. But yeah, if you like my styles of content, you can also check out my website at michaelpstanage.com. And of course, you can end up checking out our gaming Discord called The Broken Chat Box if you want to play some Dungeon Defenders 2 every once in a while. I love to play it with people, but I never end up finding people. So if you can get some people to play it, I will definitely join you at some point because it's a fun as heck game. But yeah, that's pretty much the closing comments on this one. It's an unfortunate reality that basically they just ran out of money, quite frankly, which is pretty much the story with most of these free-to-play games, especially ones from back in 2006, 2015 era. Basically, a lot of them ended up, you know, chasing popular trends, and then that just didn't end up working out, and then they ended up shutting down. And again, with the mobile market, I can't really talk about Heroes Academies 2, but I can assume it's a similar case to where they just weren't able to capture an audience, and quite frankly, it looks super generic. If I was to give, like, a first impressions thing on it from a very, very outside perspective, it looks like a generic lane defense game that just isn't very interesting, and there's 1,001 of those on mobile. So maybe that's where they made a mistake, maybe that's where they ended up running out of money, but I don't know. Honestly, I wish Orcs Must Die Unchained would have ended up getting an overhaul rather than just shutting down and trying to go back into the sort of limelight, but I can definitely see why they didn't risk that. Anyways, like I said, thanks again for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next video. And now I'm debating whether I'm actually going to finish this or go on insane mode and get my ass kicked within wave 3. Probably the latter.